Okay. Hello everybody. We are Apple, which stands for Automated Personal Protective Equipment Lookup. And we are, that's Faribos and me, we're two computer vision researchers. And we had quite a lot of fun this weekend with this challenge, which was challenge two. Per year, there's 14.9 billion pounds related to work, to injuries at the workplace, even though there's a legal requirement to wear your appropriate safety gear. So we have to find a way to automatically see whether people are wearing their equipment. And what makes this even more challenging is that there might be specific equipment for different days or for different types of persons that are entering the construction site. And overall, when we want to create an automated solution, we need a lot of data, but there's a lack of data, so we have to be clever how to efficiently use this data. We employed a TensorFlow model, and we combined it with public data, so the COCO data set, and data that we got from Ben, from Sir Robert McAlpine. And unfortunately, the data that was given initially for the challenge wasn't sufficient. So we had to come up with the, because of these requirements, and that's why we had to come up with a clever way to gather our test data. And the requirements are the following. So in order to not react or to classify something that is just laying on the ground, we have to always connect the safety equipment to a person. And also, we need positive and negative examples. So if there's an empty image, it shouldn't trigger the alarm. So what we did is we implemented a neural network that is scraping the COCO data set to find persons. And we used these persons, and we also scraped the McAlpine data set to find persons that are wearing safety equipment. And we combined our own test data set, training data set, to train, in this example, for whether people are wearing a vest or not. In the end, we envision the following solution. We envision a gate-like solution where we implement several cameras that are each attached to an individual Raspberry Pi device. And on each of these devices, we run a neural network that is detecting one specific PPE thing. And Faribos will now tell you more about what is happening in this black box.
So let's take a look inside this black box. So we choose ResNet 50, which has different convolutional layers. And the beauty of this network is it supports feature pyramid networks, which can deal with various small object sizes. And then it can be trained based on focal loss, which can handle imbalanced data, which we are facing in every challenge. And also, it has residual connections, which allow us that we can train more and go deeper to get more accurate results without any limitation. So we train these two networks, and we run it on this video. As you can see, blue shows people with jacket, safety jacket, and red shows people with safety helmet. And the detections are quite good, but this is something that's happening on Raspberry Pi. But our client side wants to receive an alarm and detect number of people that has safety. So the same video, it shows we detect three people with helmet and also with safety jacket. There are some false alarms that they can be reduced by just set a threshold over time.
Yeah. So overall, we designed a modular framework for PPE detection. And we showed that it's working with high precision for two of the safety equipments that were required. So we trained two different neural networks, one to detect helmets and one to detect jackets. And overall, the solution will be cost efficient because it's using low power and edge devices. So thank you very much.